Hi, you're with Joanna Sines and Young Lead here in Denver, Colorado at my offices, 18th and Lawrence. Joanna Sines Enterprises, look me up if you want to know. But the real reason why we're here, we have a legendary artist, Young Lead, in the building.
Yeah.
Tell us about yourself. What are you doing, Young Lead?
I'm actually out here on the road right now on a promotional tour for the new album that's going to come out next week, next Tuesday, called Preserve. I'm on Strange Music for the first time. Just signed a record deal with Strange Music. For those who are not familiar with Strange Music, it's the home of the homie Tech N9ne, Travis O'Gwynn, the president, you know, Dave Winer, so on and so forth. So, yeah, basically to sum it all up, yeah, we out on the road, me and my homie Crosside Joe, you know, promoting the new record, the Lost Cities Tour, you know what I mean, and all the things that, you know, and everything that's coming from Strange, you know what I mean, in the near future. So yeah, that's what we out here doing. Devil, you know what I mean?
Oh, that's great. It's coming out October
11th. October 11th, that's the release day. Waiting for it like Christmas, you know what I mean?
That's right, October 11th, everyone.
Yeah.
So, how did you get started?
That's a long story. I was about between 8 and 9 years old when I first started writing my own poetry and rap songs, and you know, I had, it was actually like a school booklet or pamphlet or what have we that went around to all the elementary schools in the community. And a poem that I wrote was one of the poems that made it in that book that went to our state's Capitol building. So that inspired me at 9 years old to pursue a rap career, more or less.
Wonderful. Yeah. Do you remember that poem? Can you recite it for
me? I can't remember it exactly, but I can tell you this. It really was sprung from a Run DMC song called Wake Up off of the first self-titled Run DMC album. That was like my first rap tape in life. It was that Run DMC record, and I liked that song and really looked at my community in comparison to what they was talking about in their community, and really broke that down for a 9-year-old kid at the time, and they, you know, thought it was something to it, pretty much, you know what I mean? As far as, you know, how I summed it all up, but yeah, basically that, you know.
Congratulations on all your success.
Thank you, I appreciate
it. So, I listened to 1998, what's that song, your famous song?
How You Do That, though.
That's right.
Yeah.
You were with Master P, right?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, we started out on C-Loc Records in the concentration camp. I released that song, where we released it on a concentration camp compilation in like about, I want to say, 96, 97. And it was number one in the city. Master P was coming back home. You know, to New Orleans, had a whole lot of things going on the West Coast at the time, of course, building No Limit Records, and we're shooting a movie about it, and, you know, I had a chance to connect with him throughout those times, and, you know, he liked the song, wanted to do a remake to it, which included, you know, Master P, of course, C-Loc from C-Loc Records in the concentration camp, and, you know, the rest is history for the world, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's wonderful. So you're making really good connections. You have a good name out there.
Yeah.
Little Birdie told me that Lil Wayne, you've known him since he was 13 years old.
I don't really, you know, somewhere like that, when the Hot Boys was first starting, you know, between Baton Rouge and New Orleans, like 45 minutes. So I knew Wayne when he was real young, coming through with Baby and them and a few guys in our city, Fodown Records, BK and different things. So I had a chance to meet him way back in the gap. You know, big ups to Lil Wayne, Baby Slim, all them boys, you know what I mean? Louisiana, you know, boot up, they fam for life. So yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, and your relative is Lil Boosie, right?
Me and Boosie, you know, got family ties way back home, like a long time ago. So yeah, that's my family, Free Lil Boosie, you know what I mean? Got a few things going on and back home in Louisiana. But yeah, that's my little cousin, you know what I mean? Free Lil Boosie, One Love, you know, Southside. Thug Life Wild thing, y'all know what it is already.
Yeah. All right. So let's say you're going into Strange Music right now. You're in with Strange, with Tech N9ne and all of that, correct?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Shouts out to the homie Tech N9ne, of course, you know what I mean? Real, you know, true homeboy, you know, down to earth homie, you know what I mean? One of the greatest artists it is, you know what I mean, since he began and still in his damn time. So, yeah, that's what it is. Strange Music, yeah.
It seems to be you're in a great family, you're at the right place at the right time.
Oh, yeah.
You have a lot of experience underneath your belt, the following.
Yeah.
Out here in Denver, we have nothing but love and support for you. Thank you for repping our old school gear.
Already, yeah. You know, put it in their face for the 211, so, you know, when I knew I was coming down, I actually got this at a homie named Terry back home that, you know, do a lot of the gear. I just shot my first, you know, video off the record, Holler at a Dog. So, you know, he got a shop back home. So he had this hanging in the shop and I liked it. And knew I was coming his way pretty soon. So yeah, I decided to wear it, you know, on the road trip. Yeah, you know I mean?
Blue orange is a great color, I mean.
Pretty colors, I appreciate that. Yes, ma'am.
You're very welcome.
Yeah.
Well, just a random question I'm gonna throw out there. What's your favorite artist?
Man, I got a lot. It's always hard to narrow that down in a box. You know, I had to, you know, like I say, you know, I started rapping, like I said, 8, 9 years old, like 83. So, you know, I come from the Run DMC Evolution, Sugar Hill Gang for that. So it's hard to really shuffle that, just say who's my favorite. But my favorite rapper, I say this all the time, and I always say this in a lot of my interviews, Rakim was my favorite, yeah. MC of all time, you know what I mean? And you know, my list, you know, trip it on, you know what I mean? So basically that to sum it all up in one word, you know, I learned to keep a calm persona and not scream all the time and stretch my vocal cord by listening to a calm cat like Rakim that got in, said what he needed to say, rap right in the pocket. So it went with my more kind of like my amount of persona, you know what I mean? I kind of found myself, you know, studying a lot of that when I was real young, you know what I mean? So yeah, shouts out to the OGs, the Rakim, man, always. That's what's up.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
When are you gonna perform for us out here?
I don't know at this time. I know we're coming back out here to do a signing like on the 10th of November at Angelo's, you know, the record store out here. But we're trying to, you know, put a show together, so hopefully in the next couple of weeks or so, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Cool.
Right.
Yeah,
yeah.
In a commercial, we'll be right back with you.
Yeah.
Like Pimp and Ken, Pimp and Bar, we got Mana over here, and I'ma give me some. Like D and J, a Reverend Ron, they still killing in this rap game. I got my gun.
Just gonna do this live. Don't have to dig too deep back in my archive. Got a million rhymes, man. Y'all get ready. I'm finna get it like Pimp and Ken. Pimp and Bond, we got money over here, and I'ma give me some. Like DJ, a Reverend Run, they still killing in this rap game. I got my gun, Tech 9 and Bleed. All my brother Lynch hung, this is all I need to proceed and get dumb. It's wait a minute, motherfucker, how you do that, son? Getting money overseas, blowing trees to dump. Hollin', who that? Say they want it for the Saints, going that Vince Lombardi, McCarty to run. No Prince, no car keys, I'm under the sun. Prince like Nelson Rogers, hit me over the drum. Convinced all the top thieves, I came from the slum. And went from VR, please, smoke me one. Louisiana off the handle like they favorite son. You know me, I do a big rest in peace, a big pun for real. How you do that, Vince?
This is Strange Music, that's what's up, yeah. How you do that, duh? How you do that, duh?
Cross-eyed Joe with Strange Music, who's just kicking with the boss lady. But now we gotta go, so we gotta get up out of here real quick.
How you do
that,
duh?
We're about to have about 100,000 people going up here. It's about to get a little crazy, so come on, believe, let's get out. Let's roll, let's roll. We love y'all to death. Boss Lady putting it down. Denver, Colorado. Y'all know y'all do it bigger than anyone else. Strange Music, we about to roll.
All my brother Lynch, huh? This is all I need.